Miroslav Kruzik on defense, playing for Tigers. Welcome to Tigers TV.
Pat Greene, I'm also a forward for the Tigers, and welcome to Tigers TV.
Hey guys, so how have you settled into the club itself and Telford, James?
Yeah, it's been good so far. I mean, like, obviously we're struggling with the standings, but we got games in hand and we got new guys coming in, so we should start competing a lot more right now.
So is that how it's up?
Yeah, same like James said, it's like it hasn't been too good for us this start of the season, but we're getting better right now. We need to win some games and be good.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it was tough at the beginning of the year without having the ice rink and tough to find practice ice, but we're starting to come together now. We've got a great supporting group with the fans and the Tigers Trust, and things look to be going well for the future.
And you know, you said it was a tough start, obviously, but with some new guys coming in, how do you think that's going to kind of progress through the rest of the season?
James? I think, obviously, we need depth right now, and we've got certain lines that... Well, my other lines in the league are competing with all the lines, and right now we're just not competing at that level, and I think we need to find those players, those key players for the rest that are going to step up and take us to that level.
Crazy.
Yeah, I think so. We're not doing bad, we just need to score more goals, improve like in forecheck, and that's all we need right now. If those guys can help us with that, it would be great to score more goals and be okay.
Yeah, exactly. You know, our record's not great right now, but for the most part we've been in essentially every game, minus a couple on the year. So if we just get that extra body or two to provide a little depth, and like these guys said, add a couple extra goals a game, I think we'll be all set.
I mean, individually, when Tom spoke to you about joining Tigers, what was it that persuaded you to sign for the club?
Well, for me, even being from the United States, you know, my agent spoke very highly of Tom. I really liked how the club was kind of run by the fans, and it was. A club that's on the rise, you know, a young team that's looking to improve for the future, and I'm still a pretty young player myself, so that was something that really intrigued me to come here and try to help the club move for the future.
Fantastic. Kruzik?
Well, for me, he was the first one to give me an offer after I stopped last year playing for Slovak, so it was like pretty easy decision for me. I wanted to, you know, try play hockey somewhere else than just Czech and Slovak. I was in Canada, so I was looking forward to, you know, see how it goes here, and I think so it's pretty good so far, so I'm enjoying it here.
Fantastic.
Yeah, I think it's exactly the same. It's a very intimate club here. You know you're going to be looked after. Sometimes big money clubs, they don't look after their players as well, and Telford's the perfect fit for a young player like me. Like, I get looked after, I get the exposure I need to compete at the next level, and I'm getting the opportunity to compete at the next level right now, so it's just a great fit for me right now.
Fantastic. And did you guys have offers from other places at all, or was it kind of a straightforward just coming to Tigers?
Obviously, every summer that like, you get a few offers from everywhere, but you just got to go with what feels right. And Tom was very confident with this season, and I agree with him. We got a chance to make the playoffs, and I think that's what we can do.
I never got any official offers. You know, my agent was talking to a few teams and other clubs throughout Europe. But I narrowed it down to the Tigers pretty early on. I knew that's kind of where I wanted to go before I even received an offer from Tom. So once I did, I knew that was the place for me.
Yeah, I always said before, Tom was like first one who gave me offers. So it was like 1 week we were talking about it, if you know what he can offer me here, or what I can improve here, what we can do together. So I picked it up, and good decision for me.
Fantastic. And you've all played in different leagues around Europe and kind of elsewhere in this country. How does the EPL compare to where you've played previously, James?
Well, it's a good league. Like there's a lot of experience in the league, and I think it's good as a young player to compete against that kind of level. It's a place where you can shine at such a young age, but it's also a stepping stone, and it's so many things that you can just develop on throughout the year. So it's really good.
Well, what I think, it's pretty close to the hockey in Canada or US. I don't know what parties think about it, but when I was in OHL, it's like pretty much same here. You know, it's more physical hockey than in Czech or Slovak or somewhere in Europe. There is more technique, more skilled players, but here it's like maybe a little bit faster. You know, it's up and down, so it's what I like about it. Fast game, yeah. So really good.
Yeah, exactly. It's it's a fast game up and down. I'd say it's probably a step above where I was playing back home in the States. It's a little different too in terms of my previous team. We only played about a 25 game season, so it's a much longer season. But I love it. It seems to be a great league so far.
And the supporters have really taken to all three of you since you've come joined the club. How important are the supporters to the club and to the players?
Well, I think the supporters are always important to any club, but I think especially in Telford here, where the team is actually run by the supporters, they make all the difference in the world. And for me, coming from the United States, I'm not a British player. They've been unbelievable to me, taking me in and welcoming me into their club, and I appreciate all the work that they do for the team.
Fantastic.
Exactly. I hosted party, like, they took us in, like, they do everything for us that we want, you know. They're really good to us, and I think so it's most important for me or party or any imports who come here to, you know, feel like home here. It's really good.
Fantastic. James?
I think the most important thing is that they treat you as a person and not just a number. You're not playing in a shirt. You actually belong to the team. They, on and off the ice, they look after you, and I think that's just great.
Fantastic. And, you know, earlier on we talked about it being a tough start and some new guys coming in. Obviously, this week you've got Scott McKenzie and Eurosenko coming in. How do you think that's going to kind of boost the club moving forward?
Well, personally, I don't know either of them that well. I met Scott just recently. I've seen him play twice when we played the Phoenix. He's a great forward, you know, and from what I've heard, he can put the puck in the net and score some goals. So hopefully he can, he can be that guy that we need to just get that extra goal a game and add some depth at forward. And I think Senko will do the same thing. I've never seen him play, but he's a familiar face. He's been with the Tigers before, so I'm sure he'll be a great addition.
Fantastic. kind of looking forward, what are your hopes for the rest of the season? Obviously, you've mentioned making a kind of a push for the playoffs. Is that a kind of a realistic ambition, do you think?
Yeah, I think it's definitely doable.
I think so. It's absolutely still, you know, I think so. It's 10 points right now. We have still make a playoff, you know. So I think so. If we can get those guys here and stick together as a team, make some points, it'd be great. And I think so. We can still, you know, make a playoff and some run there. So we can compete to any other team here. We're gonna, you know, play as a team, can do pretty good.
We still got some games in hand as well from the beginning of the year when we weren't playing twice a weekend, every weekend, so we still got a little ground to make up on the other teams, and you know, there's still about 30 odd games left, so there's definitely time to make a run at it.
Fantastic, guys. And then kind of individually, who's been your toughest opponent so far this season? James, I'll come to you first.
I know, like, there's a lot of good teams at the top end of this league, and there's a lot of teams we've actually battled with, so I don't think there's one team that you can pinpoint and say that this has been our toughest opponent. We've had battles against Milton Keynes, Guildford, we've kept to a few low scoring games, but throughout the league, like I said, it's hard to put one team in it.
Yeah, exactly. I think so. We were talking about it with Paddy before, that Guildford is really good team. You know, Basingstoke is there too, but you could see that we compete against those teams. And we played good against Basingstoke, Guildford, two games last week here. You know, I think so. We can beat those teams, and we can still do something damage in this league.
Okay. Yeah, I think there's great parity in the league. You know, it's a 10-team league, and I truly think on any night anyone could beat anyone. So I mean, every night's going to be a battle. It's always a hard fought physical game, and it's up to that night. Whoever shows up could pull out the win.
Fantastic. And then just turning back to the Tigers team, who's the biggest joker in the dressing room?
Yeah, we were talking about this before. Yeah. I think it should just be Sally. You know?
Yeah, I think it's definitely Sally. He's always joking around in the locker room, and it's good because he keeps the guys loose. You know, before a game, there could be nerves or anxiousness or whatever, and he always keeps the guys loose and gets them ready to go for the game.
Sounds like there's a few stories there to be
told. Oh, yeah. A few inappropriate stories. Probably shouldn't make it to TV, so.
Okay, no, he's moving on. Who's the best dressed, would you say, in the change room?
Let's see.
Timmy, maybe?
Say Tim?
Timmy's got Tim. Massive wardrobe, I think.
Tim's always looking pretty good.
Yeah. Taking care of him.
No homo.
And then moving on, finally, guys, who would you say would the award for the worst dressed person?
Definitely Thomas Silver.
He's definitely
He's awful. He's got his hair like just weird. Yeah. Like
the worst part is he thinks he's the best dressed player.
And what he wears is just so just awful.
It's tough.
Guys, that's fantastic. Thanks very much.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you.